Hi, this is the Storyboard Show, the show where we like to share stories with each other and try and figure out what, if anything, this has to do with business or how it can help us in business. I'm Ian Thompson. I run Storyboard Media. You'll have seen me in previous podcasts. They were the pilots, which is why the cameras maybe weren't quite as good. Look at us, look, we've got a second season. That means the cameras are better. We all look a little bit fitter because we're all getting paid more money now, just like what happened in season two of the OC. I've got a guest with me here today, Matt Sutton.
Hello.
Hi, Matt. Matt is from Hull. Matt is an actor. Matt, do you want to tell us a few things about you that we might not know?
Well, the things that I withhold are for good reason, Ian. I'm an actor. I'm from Hull. Do mainly theatre, bits of telly, bits of adverts every now and then. And I'm really local now. I'm a neighbour.
You've just moved back
just
to
moved
Hull,
to 825. Yeah,
two streets away from me.
Yeah, it's great. Getting used to the bins and stuff.
The cheaper way of living.
Wednesday's bins day.
Yeah.
Cheaper way of living. I don't know though, because it's thin walls in Welbeck Street.
Got
to use all the heat.
Use a lot more of the heat money.
I'm like this on the thermostat all the time. Just trying to, you know, finally balance it.
I notched my heating down 1 degree the other day.
Oh, mate, I'm like fractions of degree, like Kelvins, you know.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
So what have you been up to recently then, acting-wise, job-wise?
I've been doing more voiceover stuff.
Okay.
It's acting still, it's still kind of related, but it's more, it's like a sort of side thing. A lot of actors do voiceover, and there are voiceovers who just do voiceover, and there are actors who don't do voiceover at all. But I've set up a little studio, and I've done quite a bit over the years.
It's quite nice because you get to work from home, I guess, isn't it?
Yeah, you can sort of sit in your underpants and sound like you're kind of...
You're going to need the heating up high for that, though, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I've got a little oil-filled heater that I sit on, which is kind of... Brilliant. That kind of covers that. And you save money. I've been sort of doing a bit more of that. Just kind of putting my new website together, recording a few new demos and stuff, and just trying to get a bit better at that because it's a particular sort of skill.
Yeah, it's a tough one, isn't it? Because when people can't see we were talking before we started this, and we were saying like, you know, acting is very similar to filmmaking in that, you know, you're trying to tell the story in a way that it's slightly more difficult, I'd say, the acting wise, because it's more difficult to tell the audience what to look at in order to tell that story. You know, you can't cut to a hand doing something or cut to a look or something like that. You've got to direct the audience's attention towards that.
Yeah, I think, and the director in any sort of situation, be it, well, particularly for theatre, they're trying to shape the telling of that story. And in a way, they are kind of like sort of choosing the shots. They're kind of trying to, with the lighting or how they kind of block the scene, how they kind of put where they put the actors on stage, they're sort of telling the audience where to focus at any sort of given time. That's theatre is the original storytelling form.
Absolutely.
In the Greeks, that's how the Greeks told stories.
True. And I suppose voiceover is even more difficult in a sense because even though, I mean, all right, you don't know what you're reading, it might be a radio advert, it could be a manual for something, but also a lot of them, it's stories and things like that, like audiobooks are very big at the moment. Mm-hmm. And I guess that's even more difficult because people, again, don't even have the blocking, they don't have the facial expressions, they can't watch your lips. And I think a lot of the time with voiceover stuff, you know, because obviously we have a lot of voiceovers in the films that we make, things like that, it's even more difficult because people can't see them. You don't realise how much you pick up on expressions in people's faces, albeit tiny ones. Mm. You don't realise how much you use, you know, watching people's lips to realise what they're saying. Mm. It actually, you know, when you get down to doing voiceover, it's really difficult. I always say to people who maybe aren't used to doing voiceovers that they're doing for us, when you think you're too over the top, you're probably about right.
Mm. Yeah. I think the thing with audio, particularly with radio plays, is that you've got sound effects and you've got in the mind of the and in the ears of the listener, they're all their experience. So you can have the biggest budget fantasy sort of setup for a radio play, and all you need is a few decent sort of you need a good script and decent kind of sound effects, and then you can create anything in the mind of the listener. That's what's brilliant about radio. But for things like sort of commercials, you've got 30 seconds to tell a story. And you've got to do it in a really sort of condensed, compact way. So there's a real, real skill to sort of trying to do something, trying to sell something and sell an idea and a story in 30 seconds.
Yeah. So, like, being an actor then, what do you think actors can bring to people's voiceovers? So we've sort of changed tack here. We originally weren't going to talk about voiceovers loads, but actually it's really interesting. Yeah, and it sort of it links up with the film stuff that we do. And yeah. So I think it's really interesting. What can actors, because a lot of people, that we get a lot of clients who'll sort of say like, no, I'll do my own voiceover. Yeah, sometimes that's absolutely fine. They might be pretty good at it. But sometimes it's not easy doing a voiceover, is it?
Yeah, I think as well, fashions change. You know, you sort of get 80s voiceovers. Come and get a sofa from them. And then you go back to sort of the path they knew when people spoke like that and very quickly. And now there's a thing where people want a distinctive, really natural sounding voice. They don't want a cheesy kind of voiceover voice.
There's a lot of research done, wasn't there, a few years ago, probably around the time that like Big Brother was at its peak and things like that, about what kind of regional voice people liked best for sales wise. I'm mentioning Big Brother because the guy's got such a strong Geordie accent who voiceovers that. Yeah.
But he kind of breaks the mold for voiceover. Normally you'd think, well, you'd get a kind of voice of God like Peter Dixon to kind of do something like that. But the guy who does kind of Come Dine With Me, he's really famous now because of his sort of sardonic,
but
sarcastic
voice. It doesn't need to be that sort of estuary English accent kind of thing, does it?
No, it doesn't. And I think when you do hear a different voice, and you sort of tune in, you go, oh, that sounds a bit like a friend of mine or something.
Yeah, yeah.
It doesn't sound like somebody who knocks out sort of 10 voiceovers a day and isn't really concentrating on what they're saying.
Like the American ones when they have to talk really, really fast to fit in all the T's and C's.
Yeah, well, that's a skill, yeah, because you have to do that. That's still a thing. You can't. There's no small print. It's just fast talking. Yeah. There are people doing voiceover now who are not sort of trained and they're not sort of doing that old thing. And people, you know, we're always looking for novelty, and that's the same for the sort of voiceover industry as well.
I suppose, like you say, you do get voiceover artists that maybe don't do acting and things like that. Mm. And not knocking them at all, I'm sure there's some really, really good ones
around.
I think
sometimes they're better because actors kind of bring some kind of, well, projection for a start.
But that's not a bad thing, though. I mean, you know, it's... But also, actors have got that experience of telling the story. Mm. And, you know, like we say, like whether you're doing a 30-second advert, whether you're doing a manual or something like that, whether you're doing an audiobook, you're telling a story still. You're still trying to draw the audience in. I mean, it can't just be boring. It can't just, you know.
No, absolutely not.
It's going to be better if you're taking the audience on a journey. All right, that's going to be difficult on a manual, maybe, but...
Yeah, well, I sort of do some e-learning stuff, and some of it's quite dry. It's about legal conveyancing law and all that sort of thing. But you've got to remember that there are people listening to this who've got to sit there for a few hours and try and take this information in. And if... I mean, you could just put it through a speech, where they're kind of just speech generator.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're not going to learn anything. So you've got to
I've had a voiceover company that I think did that to me once.
Really?
And I was demanding to speak to the person who was doing it so I could give us some direction.
They synthesised your voice?
They wouldn't let me speak to the person who's doing it.
Really?
And I think it's because they were sending me a voiceover from a computer-generated one. Because it sounded computer generated. I kept saying to them, I want it with no compression. I want it absolutely raw, with nothing on.
Right.
And they just couldn't do it.
Right.
Because I think it was just computer generated.
It was just Siri.
Exactly.
Or the guy who didn't get the Siri gig, who they had all these kind of vowels and everything. And that's right.
So we've been talking a lot about voiceovers. On the Storyboard Show, you know, we like to share stories, things like that. We haven't necessarily shared a story, but we've found out a lot about Matt and we've talked a lot about stories. One question we always like to ask is, what can this teach us about business? It's a difficult one, this, because it's not necessarily a story we've been talking about, but I think, I mean, what do you think?
About
what we've been talking about today, what can it teach us about business?
I think that people, well, in the whole history of kind of humanity, stories have been used to influence people, to sort of get people on your side, to convince people to fight for you, literally, you know? We talk about the Greeks and the Romans. That was their entertainment. They got together and they told stories. And the same thing is true. If you want to engage people and get them to sort of engage in something that you're advertising or that you want to raise awareness for, you need to tell a story. You can't just give them bare facts. You need to embroider those facts in. to a story.
And that's why Matt's an actor, because he came up with something far more poetic than I was going to come up with.
That's what the writers do.
It was lovely, I was going to say diversification, because Matt does TV, does theatre, and he's diversified into voiceover as well. Yeah. So, you know, we got a couple of things there, but yours was far more beautiful and interesting than mine, with historical things to back it up. So, yeah, okay. Well, thanks. Oh, finally, Matt.
Yeah.
One question that we have been asking people, a number of things we've been asking people.
Is this
people.
The Columbo moment?
Yeah, we just like to drop something on people occasionally. Right. Matt, in a story of your life, who would play you? And why?
Well, why would they tell my story in a film, for a start? But
that wasn't the why I was asking, but yeah.
I think probably sort of, I think I look a bit like John Sim.
See that.
But he's older than me, so he could play the older version. Who would play the story of my life? I don't know, really.
It's one of those things that everyone always discusses in the pub.
Well, me, hopefully.
Why
would I give
him... Matt Sutton as himself.
Like, you know, can you imagine auditioning for the story of your life and not getting it? How much of a nightmare would that be? Nice. Mate, we thought you were great, just not quite right for this particular part. What, to play me? Thanks.
All right, well, thanks ever so much. Cheers, Matt. Thanks for coming in. This is Matt Sutton, based in Hull, can go anywhere, actor.
Can go anywhere? Yeah. Well, within reason.
Yeah, voiceover artist, you name it. He diversifies. Yeah. That's been the Storyboard Show for this week. Thanks very much, and join us again. Thanks, Matt.